Good evening, and welcome to another spooky Wrath of Math lesson. Tonight, we'll be proving that set intersection distributes over set union. You're probably already familiar with the typical distributive property for multiplication and addition. We know that, for example, A times B plus C is equal to A times B plus A times C. The multiplication distributes over the addition. Set intersection behaves in the same sort of way with set union, and that's what we'll be proving today. So let's just be super clear about what we are proving. Let me adjust my very spooky robe here, make sure that it's on correctly, and let's write it out. So what are we proving? We're proving that for three sets, A, B, and C, A intersect B union C. In this situation, intersection distributes over the set union, so that this is equal to A intersect B unioned with A intersect C. Just like that, works the same sort of way as multiplication and addition. As it turns out, union also distributes over set intersection this same way, which is pretty cool, and we'll prove that in another lesson. You can also give that a swing yourself after watching this one. Now, it's a basic set equality proof. Remember, to prove that two sets are equal, first, we'll need to show that this set is a subset of this set. Then we'll need to show that this set is a subset of this set. It's all fairly straightforward, although it is a bit repetitious, which can make it difficult to understand by listening, because I'll be saying, you know, set and subset and is an element of, saying those things over and over again, which can sometimes make it a little tricky to follow. Before we get into that proof, let's just see a Venn diagram, which will quickly convince us that this result is in fact true. So for the Venn diagram, we'll just have these three circles representing our sets A, B, and C. What is A intersect B union C? Well, B union C is B and C, all the stuff in those two sets. If we just take what is in common with B union C and A, that intersection, if we just take what's in common with A, that's just going to be all of this stuff that I'm shading now. All right, so that's A intersect B union C. What about this? What's A intersect B union A intersect C? Well, A intersect B is right there. A intersect C is right there. And oh, look, if we union them, we get A intersect B union C, which we already shaded. So we can quickly convince ourselves that yes, this result is true. Now let's go ahead and get into the actual proof, which again is pretty straightforward, but is a little monotonous. All right, first things first, we want to show that this set is a subset of this set. To do that, we begin with an arbitrary element from this set. So we'll say let x be an element of our set on the left, A intersect B union C. We just need to show that if we take any arbitrary element from this set, which is what we've just done, we need to show that it must also be an element of this set. That will prove our desired subset relation. So let's get into it. What do we know about X if it belongs to this set? Well, we know that certainly X has to be an element of A by definition of set intersection. X has to be an element of A, and X has to be an element of B union C. So we could write that here, X is an element of A, and X is an element of B union C. Okay, now what does this mean for X to be an element of B union C? Well, there are basically two cases. Case one would be that X is an element of B. If X is an element of the set B, well, we know that X is an element of A. So if X was also an element of B, that would mean that X is an element of A intersect B. Thus, by definition of set union, if X is an element of A intersect B, then X is an element of A intersect B union A intersect C. And so we'll write that here. This would imply that X, by definition of set union, has to be an element of A intersect B union A intersect C. All right. Case 2 goes basically the exact same way. Case 2 would be that X is an element of C. Now, there is a sort of third case where X is an element of both B and C, but note that case is covered by both of these cases. If X is an element of B and C, then case 1 applies, and so does case 2, so we're still covered. There's only two cases we have to think about. If X is an element of C, what do we know? Same sort of thing. We're guaranteed that X is an element of A. So if X is an element of C, then X is an element, by definition of set intersection, of A intersect C. Then, by definition of set union, if X is an element of this set, X is an element of that set. And so we see we are guaranteed if we take an arbitrary element from A intersect B union C, it must be the case that element is also an element of A intersect B union A intersect C. Thus, by definition of subset, we have our desired subset relation that A intersect B union C must be a subset of A intersect B union A intersect C. Because we just showed that any element of this set also has to be an element of that set, so we get our desired subset relation. Now, the second part of the proof, we just have to show that this set is also a subset of this set, and then we'll be done. We will have our desired set equality. All right, so I erased most of what was on the board, so we got some more room to work with. You can, of course, rewind the video if you want to take another close look at what we had previously written. Again, now we want to show that this is a subset of this. So we begin by taking an arbitrary element from this set, and we just have to show that element must also belong to this set. So we'll say let X be an element of A intersect B union A intersect C. Now this means, by definition of set union, that X is an element of A intersect B, or X is an element of A intersect C. This basically gives us a two-case situation again. We could have case 1, X is in A intersect B, or case 2, X is in A intersect C. There's a sort of case 3, again, where X is in both of these sets, but if X is in both sets, then it's covered by each of the individual cases that we're looking at. So, let's say that X is an element of A intersect B. What does that mean? Well, that would mean that X is an element of A, so we could write that underneath here. X is an element of A, and it means, of course, X is an element of B. But if X is an element of B, then, by definition of set union, that would mean that X is an element of B union C. Oh, look. So that means if X is in A intersect B, that means that X is in A and X is in B union C. Thus, by definition of set intersection, we would have our desired result that X is an element of A intersect B union C. Of course, the second case goes a very similar way. So I'll just draw sort of a curvy line here to divide these two cases. So case 2, let's say that X is an element of A intersect C. That means, by definition of set intersection, that X is an element of A. It also means that X is an element of C. But if X is an element of C, then, by definition of set union, that means that X is an element of B union C. And then once again, we have our desired result. Since X has to be in A and X is in B union C, that means, by definition of set intersection, that X is an element of A intersect B union C, as we desired. So in total, we see that any arbitrary element of this set, A intersect B union A intersect C, must also belong to A intersect B union C. So we've just shown that, I'll write it down here, we've just shown that A intersect B union A intersect C is a subset of A intersect B union C. In the previous step of the proof, of course, we showed that this is a subset of this. Thus, we can now conclude, since they are both subsets of each other, A intersect B union A intersect C is in fact equal to A intersect B union C, which is what we wrote above, just in the opposite order. And there we go. That's how we prove that set intersection distributes over a union in exactly the way we would expect. Just takes some knowledge of how to prove set equality, knowledge of the definition of subset, set union, set intersection, and pretty easy road from there. So I hope this video helped you understand the proof. Let me know in the comments if you've got any questions, need anything clarified, or have any other video requests. Thank you very much for watching. If you'd like to help support Wrath of Math and these spooky lessons, I'd really appreciate a small donation on PayPal or small monthly pledge on Patreon. I'll leave links to those in the description. Thank you very much for watching.
I'll see you next time, and be sure to subscribe for the spookiest math lessons on the internet.